On today's episode, I'm going to show you a simple hotend fix for any Creality machine. Ender 3, CR-10, CR-10 Mini, Ender 5, any of them. It makes your hotend work better longer with less stringing and less issues. I'll show you what it is on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. All this starts back in January of 2019. I found Luke Hatfield's or One Bad Marine's fix on Thingiverse for the hot end, and I made a custom coupling, a 3D printed coupling that would go on the top of your hot end and screw in place. Well, that coupling didn't work out. After a couple months, it broke. I printed a new one. It broke. I finally just abandoned the design. I still have the video out there if you want to watch it. But what came out of it was I found that Luke Hatfield's design was really, really good. In fact, this machine has been running for 14 months without any issues. The only reason I'm going to take it apart is for today's video. This all starts with the Creality hot end design. Most of the Creality machines, the CR-10, CR-10 Mini, Ender 3, all have the same design that the PTFE tubing goes into the hot end and butts up against the nozzle. And you need that tight against the nozzle because if there's any gap, you'll get leakage, you get blockage, you get extrusion issues. I did a whole video on that previously. And mine, the problem was the coupling. The coupling did not hold up and it let the PTFE tubing back off. And so you can get better couplings, and I've showed that. And you can go with better tubing, like Capricorn tubing. But you don't need to go that far, because what Luke Hatfield came up with was a very clever design. And that is, and this is a mock-up of the hot end, that is to take a small piece of PTFE tube, put it inside the hot end, then put a washer, little plastic washer on top of it, and then take your coupling, slide it down to the end, and screw that on top. And as you screw this down, you're pinching that little piece of PTFE tubing tight against the nozzle. And that's what I installed on this Ender 3. Instead of using standard PTFE tubing, though, I used Capricorn tubing for the insert. And that's because Capricorn tubing has a higher temperature rating than the PTFE tube that comes with the Ender 3. So what I did is cut a small piece of Capricorn, put it in there for my insert, and this thing has run 14 months flawlessly. In fact, it would continue running that good if I didn't take it apart for this video. Now, why is that important? It's because I've found on a stock machine, and I have several Creality machines to attest to this, the last 20 millimeters of your PTFE tube that touch that hot end tends to bake or deform or lose its lubrication. Now, some will say it's PTFE tube, it can't lose its lubrication, but here's what I found. If I cut that last 20 millimeters off and then slide the PTFE tubing down, all my stringing, all my issues go away. If I do the old trick where you take a piece of sponge, put some olive oil on it, clamp it over the filament going into the extruder, let it run a little bit and then take it off, it lubricates it enough that that thing will do about 20 or 30 prints with no stringing, no issue. So basically adds lubrication to that last 20 millimeters of PTFE. On this machine with the insert, I used Capricorn tubing for that little insert. And because of that, the last 20 millimeters has not been damaged. Because of that higher temperature resistance of Capricorn, this thing went 14 months and would go longer with no stringing, no issues. In fact, some of my machines back here that have Capricorn going from the nozzle all the way up to the extruder have done the same. I've had no issues. I haven't had to cut off that last 20 millimeters. So there's definitely a difference in the PTFE tubing and how it handles that last bit of heat right at the nozzle. And that's what gives you problems on a stock Ender 3 or CR-10 that the Capricorn eliminates. But there's one issue with Capricorn I really don't like, and that's the inner diameter. The inner diameter is 1.9 millimeters, where the diameter of the stock PTFE tubing is more around the range of 2 millimeters. Now, there's a common belief that the larger diameter is worse for stringing and retraction because the filament can actually wiggle and wind in there. And so when you retract, you're actually just unwinding it instead of actually pulling it back and retracting, you're going to get more stringing. And the longer your PTFE tubing, the worse that issue is. But I haven't found that. I did a video recently where I did different lengths of PTFE tubing and it didn't affect the stringing at all. What affected it most was that last 20 millimeters that wasn't working properly. So I actually like to use the stock PTFE tubing from an EZR extruder, which gives me very consistent flow, and I can print with flexibles, I can print with pretty much any material I want, and I get good pressure, good force of the filament, and then go through the stock PTFE tubing, which is a bigger diameter, but then down here in the hot end, that's where you have the Capricorn, and it's nice and straight. It's not bent like this, so you have less resistance, and it goes straight in right to the nozzle. And with Luke Hatfield's fix, it's squeezed tight against the nozzle. And so to me, this is the best hot end setup that I have in my shop. An EZR extruder, the stock larger diameter PTFE, and the Capricorn tubing insert. 14 months ago, when I did the Luke Hatfield insert on this machine, I didn't tell people how long to make the PTFE tube insert. And I did that on purpose. I have a lot of comments asking how long to make it, and I said, well, you got to measure your hot end. And people didn't understand, because Luke Hatfield has guides to cut your PTFE tubing based on your machine. But I've got a lot of different Creality machines and various generations, and what I found is they're not consistent. So the guide, I don't know how that works, because this machine right here is like 40 millimeters depth, and this one is 36. So it's like a 4 millimeter difference between these two. So if I give you a tube based on this one, it's gonna be too long in this one. So I'm gonna install it on this, and I'll show you how to measure yours so you get the right length. And then just use a cutter like a Capricorn, a really good cutter that cuts straight, to cut your PTFE tubing, and then you'll have the perfect size insert. The first thing you wanna do is heat up your hot end, remove the filament from the PTFE tubing, and then let this thing cool and unplug it. The next step is to unscrew the coupling here at the hot end and pull the PTFE tubing out of the hot end. Now we need to measure for our insert. And how I do that is I just take a piece of 2.85 or 3 millimeter filament and straighten it out and put it inside the hot end, push it against the nozzle, take a marker, mark it level with the top of the hot end, and then I measure this. And it doesn't have to be perfect, as long as you're close. You can use a caliper if you want. But this one's measuring 35 millimeters. I think I said 36 earlier. It's 35 millimeters deep from the top of the nozzle to the top of the hot end. Now, if you don't have this size filament, you can use 1.75, which comes with your machine. Just make sure you get to the edge. Push to the edge so you're on the edge of the nozzle and not inside the center of the nozzle. Because if it's a clean nozzle, this will actually slide into the center. Now I also use something different, and that's my washer. This is my own washer I designed in Tinkercad. It's got a funnel effect on the top, and it's a little bit stronger. I like this, it's 4 millimeters thick, and then I like to get about three millimeters of thread on the coupling when I screw it in, so that's 7 millimeters. So 35 millimeters minus the 7 millimeters says I have to cut my insert 28 millimeters long. I just take the Capricorn tool, put it on the piece of PTFE, and cut it to 28 millimeters. I have my 28 millimeter piece ready to insert, and what I should have mentioned is before you take all this apart, print your washer. It only takes a few minutes to print, but you gotta have this printed ahead of time. So print that first before you do any of these steps. So I have the washer, have the insert, drop it into the hot end. It goes in pretty easy. Then the washer, the flat side down, the concave or funnel side up, put it in there. And then just push it down with your thumb. And now the coupling, you want to slide this off the PTFE tubing, blow any little particles out of it, and then start screwing this in place by hand. And then you want to use a wrench to finish it. And just tighten this until you feel it's firm, because you're squishing that PTFE down. So just tighten it. It's going to take, I don't know, 1.5 or 2 turns. And then you'll feel it tighten up. And once that's in place, then you can insert the PTFE tube all the way in to that washer, and it's ready to print. I loaded the filament, it's printing good. In fact, it printed this box for a future electronics project, so stay tuned for that. The only improvements I wanna make now is I wanna replace this extruder with an EZR extruder and get this spool mounted to the side. This is actually a really simple fix, but really effective at making your hot end much better. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up if you wanna help support the channel. Patreon is really helpful, and all the parts and things I use for my videos are linked in the description below. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time, right here at Filament Friday.